Next, we can move on to GATE or IAS questions, which is very conceptual. In this session, we are taking only small questions which are asked in previous IAS question paper. Also, it may be important for GATE also. So, we are discussing here IAS questions. So first question, minimum clear cover to the main steel bars in slab B, column and footing respectively are. Here, according to IS 456-2000, minimum clear cover for slab is 20 mm and for column is 40 mm, beam is 25 mm, footings 50 mm. So the answer matching the correct answers are not here. So the answer is none of this. Moving to second question. The maximum strain in concrete at the outermost compression fiber in the limit state design of flexural member is. Option A 0.0020, option B 0.0035, option C 0.0065, option D 0.0050. The correct answer is option B 0.0035 as per IS 456-2000. Third question. Side face reinforcement is provided in a beam when the depth of web exceeds. Option A 300 mm, option B 450 mm, option C 500 mm, option D 750 mm. Here the correct option is option D 750 mm. Side face reinforcement is provided only when depth of web is exceeding 750 mm. Then moving to fourth question. High yield deformed bars have a option A definite yield value, option B chemical composition different from mild steel, option C percentage elongation less than that of mild steel, option D percentage elongation more than that of mild steel. So the answer is option C. HYST bars are more brittle, having lesser percentage of elongation. So option C is correct answer. Then fifth question. In an RCC beam, side face reinforcement is provided if its depth exceeds. It is already discussed. The option D is the correct answer. Only when depth of the beam exceeds 750 mm, we have to provide side face reinforcement of 0.1% of the whole cross section area. Next question. When assessing the strength of a structure as per the limit state of collapse, the value of partial safety factor for steel is taken as. For steel, partial safety factor is taken as 1.15. So option C is the correct answer. Then seventh question. In an RCC beam of breadth B and overall depth B exceeding 750 mm side face, 750 mm side face reinforcement required and the allowable R of maximum tension reinforcement shall be respectively. Here the option is C. Correct option is option C. When overall depth of a beam exceeds 750 mm, side face reinforcement of 0.1% of curb area is required. Maximum tension reinforcement in beams should not exceed 4% cross section area. So the option is C. Correct option is option C. Moving to 8th question. As per IS 456-1978, ratio of stress in concrete to its characteristic strength in collapse in flexure for design purposes is taken as. Here, in limit state of failure, flexure, collapse, the ratio of stress in concrete to its characteristic strength is 0.447. So, option C is the correct answer. Option C, 0.447. 9th question. Consider the following statements. First one, keeping simile content within the range of 330 kg per meter cube to 530 kg per meter cube. Second one, using well graded aggregate with water cement ratio is less than 0.5. 3. Controlling the permissible stress in steel by the strain and crack width rather than strength. Fourth one, providing minimum steel of any grade amounting to 0.3%. Which of these measures have been recommended by IS 33701970 for the design of leak proof liquid containers of impervious concrete? So, according to IS 33701970, all these statements are correct. So, we can choose option A. Moving to the next question. If modular ratio is M, effective depth is D, this and stress ratio is R. R is equal to ratio of sigma ST and sigma CS, the depth of neutral axis of a balanced section is. Here, we have to consider the crack retransformation section in the case of working stress method. So, we have to draw a section like this. Here, this one is the normal B. Here is the cracked transformed section. Here is the stress diagram. So, from this stress diagram, we can apply the law of triangle. While applying the law of triangle, we can write it as sigma CBC divided by KD. KBD. KD means is the depth of neutral axis. Sigma CBC divided by KBD is equal to sigma ST by M, sigma ST by M divided by D minus KB. Here, sigma ST by M is done because we have to convert the stress in steel into stress in concrete. So, we can write it as this. Sigma ST by M is equal to sigma CBC into D minus KBD divided by KB. Here, after done all these calculations, we will get KB as M by M plus M. We know the effective depth of neutral axis in working stress method is KB into D. So, M by M plus R into D. So, option B is the correct answer. Here, 11, it is a matching type question. Match list 1 with the list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below. So, list 1 contains A. Minimum percentage of tension reinforcement of RCB. B. Minimum percentage of shear reinforcement of RCB. C. Maximum allowable percentage of tension reinforcement of RCB. D. Maximum allowable percentage of compression reinforcement of RCCB. So, first one, minimum percentage of tension reinforcement of RCB. What is the minimum percentage of tension reinforcement? The minimum percentage of tension reinforcement of RCB is 85 by Fi. Here, actually, it is 0.85 by Fi. So, I have to be given into the percentage, we have to multiply it. 85 by Fi. Then B. Minimum percentage of shear reinforcement of RCB. Here minimum percentage of shear reinforcement is 40 SP divided by Fe into T. Actually, the equation for minimum shear reinforcement is ASP by BSP is equal to 0.4 by 8.87 Fi. While doing some calculations, we will get it like that. Then, see maximum allowable percentage of tension reinforcement of RCB. So, maximum allowable tension reinforcement is 4%. Then, option D is then at last. Maximum allowable percentage of compression reinforcement of RCCB. Maximum allowable compression reinforcement. RCCB. is also 4%. So option A is the correct. Option A is the correct option. So 12. Moving to the 12th question. Partial safety factor for concrete and steel are 1.2 and 1.15 respectively. Because A. Concrete is heterogeneous while steel is homogeneous. B. Control on the quality of concrete is not as good as that of steel. C. Concrete is weak in tension. D. Voids in concrete are 0.5% while those in steel are 0.15%. Here the correct answer is option B. Because quality control in making of steel is less than that of steel. So quality control in making of concrete is less than that of steel. Concrete is a heterogeneous material. Therefore, higher partial safety factor is required for concrete. Moving to 13th question. As per IS 456, side force reinforcement, side face reinforcement not less than 0.05% web area is provided on each side when the depth of the web is not less than 750 mm. Option D is the correct answer. Moving to 14th question. Consider the following statements. The reinforcement in reinforced concrete shall have concrete cover. The thickness of such cover shall be not less than. First one, 25 mm. Second one, diameter of bar. Third one, spacing between bars. Fourth one, 5 mm. Here, the correct answer is option D. Nominal cover to the reinforcement should not be less than 25 mm or diameter of the bar. According to IS 456, 2000.